Hello, I'm Arnaud Delorme, and this presentation is about recording data using the lab streaming layer, also known as LSL. We will record EEG data, of course, which is what LSL was originally designed for. I'm going to do a short demo here. First, we will see the easy way to collect data using lab streaming layer and the Matlab Viewer Recorder EEGLAB plugin. Then we will see the standard way using the LabRecorder program. I've turned on my Muse EEG headset and I put it on. Here I will use a Muse headset because it's simple to demo and a lot of people have one, but you can use any headset supported by the LSL protocol. There is a website showing the more than 100 devices supported by LSL. Here you can select your device, you can download the LSL software to connect to it. I put a link to the website in the description. Then I start the LSL software to connect to the Muse headset. Each EEG device and each device in general that can produce an event stream has its own software, often provided by the manufacturer. I then start Matlab and EEGLAB, and then I install the Matlab Viewer Recorder plugin using the EEGLAB plugin manager. I search for LSL. After installing the plugin, I select the plugin menu to connect to the LSL stream. It will automatically detect all streams available, and I can select the stream if there are several. I will just use the default here. The program connects to the stream and I can now see my data. I can then press the record button to record it. Data is not great. There is one bad channel here. This is just for demo. I'm going to press the stop button and enter the file name to save the data. And I now have a regular EEGLAB dataset that I can use as I would any other EEGLAB dataset. First, I'm going to load it, and then I'm going to plot it. I need to change the scaling and also remove the DC offset. Sometimes you might have the last EEG channel containing event markers. It's not the case here. If I had an event channel, I can use this EEGLAB menu to import events. So this previous solution has limitations. You can only visualize and save a single stream. I'm going to show you the approach most people use. We will record the EEG streams using a tool called the LabRecorder that saves files in the XDF format. I put the link to download this tool in the description. Then we're going to import the data in EEGLAB. So we have not stopped the streaming EEG data. I start the LabRecorder program, select the EEG stream, then start recording. This is not a MATLAB program, it's a Python program. When I use the LabRecorder program, I cannot see the EEG. If I wanted to visualize the EEG, I can use other tools such as the Matlab Viewer I just showed you. Also, I'm using the Mac version, but there is a Windows and a Linux version. Now I'm stopping the data acquisition. This saves the data as a file in the XDF format. So what do we do with this file? Well, we go back to EEGLAB and we can install the XDF importer. There's two ways to import XDF files. I will show you both here. First, we'll use the XDF plugin. This one can only import one stream of EEG data. You just select the files we just created and import it. And we're also going to plot it. So this is similar to plotting the previous data. And the main difference here, so we have to remove the DC offset, scale the data. The main difference is with this solution is that with the LabRecorder, you can record multiple streams. So now we're going to try the other way, which is using the MobiLab plugin. First, we need to install the plugin, of course. This plugin will allow you to select different streams and align them, to resample them, to match the EEG sampling rate. So here, I'm going to select a file with multiple streams. This is actually synchronizing two EEG headsets, and we also have event streams and other synchronized devices. I will select the two EEG streams in the right column and the event stream in the left column and then press OK. Now I can plot the data and scroll the data. I'm going to remove the DC offset. I'm also going to select the larger event window of 30 seconds. You can see the two synchronized EEG streams and the event as vertical line. The first 16 EEG channels are the EEG for the first person, and the next 16 EEG channels are the EEG for the second person. If you're serious about synchronizing streams using LSL, this is the way to do it. We're going to go into a little bit more details about the way things work in LSL. First, what is the LSL protocol? The LSL protocol was developed by Christian Koff, who was an application programmer in our laboratory at UCSD. LSL is a real-time streaming protocol that allows synchronizing different data streams at different sampling rates. So we may have an EEG stream at 512 Hz and an eye tracking stream at 50 Hz, and LSL will ensure that these are synchronized. LSL can handle streams with uniform sampling rates and streams with non-uniform sampling rates, such as event streams. You can also collect data on different computers connected to the same local network. You can stream from a Mac to a PC through the network and vice versa. In general, for the sake of stability, Windows is usually better supported. When using the XDF format to save streams, as we've done before, some synchronization information is saved. So each stream is recorded with sub-millisecond accuracy by the computer that collects it. As the stream is dispatched to the network, there is also some synchronization information included. LSL uses a ping mechanism to synchronize streams. So let's imagine this setup where we record EEG from two headsets on different computers. Then as LSL stream data through the local Wi-Fi network, we want to save them in the XDF file using the LabRecorder application. Note that here I have three computers, but the same could happen on a single computer that could run LSL apps for each of the two headsets and run the LabRecorder application simultaneously. Each recorder will transfer the data to the local network, but in addition to the data, the LabRecorder application will save ping time with each of the two LSL apps every couple of seconds. These ping times are stored in the XDF files and may be used to synchronize the stream when imported in EEGLAB or other software. Now, a word about event streams. Mouse click and keyboard events can be recorded with event streams, and they're also synchronized with other streams. In theory, you can achieve sub-millisecond precision synchronization, but this really depends on your settings. In one of our settings, for example, we recorded the actual latency of events and LSL events latency, and you can see a pretty large jitter up to 20 milliseconds shown here. Which is very large considering EEG experiment. This is probably an extreme example, but do not assume that the synchronization is perfect, and more importantly, test the synchronization. Many factors can affect synchronization, such as the architecture of your network, your router, the load of your network, the load of the computer, the way LSL apps record events, etc. If you're using continuous streams with fixed sampling rates, it's not so important. Since the sampling rates are fixed, you simply have to align them the best you can using all the available ping times. So if you have jitter on some of the pings, it's not a big deal as they'll be averaged out. However, if you have streams with irregular sampling rates, such as discrete events, it's important to check that your setup supports proper synchronization using LSL. This is why I personally still record events in the EEG data channel and not as an LSL event stream. Hopefully, as LSL is increasing in popularity, there will be more tools to look into these synchronization issues. What is this clown doing here? So I hope you've enjoyed this video. Press the bell button to be notified when new videos are released, and thanks for watching.